Hey guys, so I've got another distribution sort of first impressions video for you today. Today we're looking at the latest Mate version of Manjaro. So this is just the Manjaro distribution with the Mate desktop. This is a rather new community spin. As you can see, it's 1606 built against the development branches so far by the looks of it. Daniela. So this is just installed into a virtual machine, and as you can see, I've just let it boot up. So I was very impressed with the Ubuntu Mate edition, and I'm growing increasingly impressed with the Mate desktop as a full-featured desktop that doesn't have that doesn't use too much in the way of system resources. It's easy to use, and it, you know, it's sort of the it has good attributes across the board. And one of the things I really like about the Mate desktop is that it's just really easy to navigate. The applications are all neatly, you know, tidied away in the applications menu. The places are all in the places menu, and the system stuff is all in the system menu. So if you wanted to configure your system, for example, preferences and the menu system, I personally find to be incredibly easier, a lot easier than some of the other sort of control panel, interfaces that other distributions have. So you get a lot of options here, but at least you know, sort of, you know, they're categorized nicely. And I've always felt this was the first distribution that I ever... No, this is the second desktop environment that I ever really used at any length. The first was KDE, unsurprisingly, because it came with SUS. But my first, like, distribution I used that took me through university was Fedora with the old GNOME 2 desktop, which is effectively what Mate has become. And it was, I always found it easy. I always found it customizable. You can have one bar at the bottom if you want to do a bit of space conservation. You could even do, you know, system sort of panels on the side. The volume tools are actually quite good. This, in fact, comes with pulse audio controls, which are always pretty good. It's all pretty basic here because, of course, I'm running it inside of a virtual machine. But it's interesting to see that it's actually picked up my USB microphone as a... as the sort of the built-in microphone, so that's pretty interesting. So yeah, it gives it's all very easy, all very straightforward. A lot of distributions sort of cover these bases, but it's nice to see that Manjaro do it too, because I really quite like Manjaro as a distribution. It is my daily driver, except I'm on the XFCE build, and the reason I chose the XFCE build is because it's Manjaro's flagship distribution sort of layout. But that's not to say that the community distributions aren't worth a look. I would say treat each community distribution and each community sort of respin it as a beast in its own right. So it does have access, of course, to all the Manjaro tools and all the Manjaro repositories, and anything you've got on one community distribution you can simply install on another without any real major kind of problems. But that being said, this definitely looks like one of the better, you know, like a particularly good build. Everything seems in place. I like the theme. In fact, what I like about the theme is that the Manjaro distribution is moving towards this theme. It's called Vertex. They've put their own spin on it. They've made it their own color green and all that kind of stuff. And I really do quite like this theme as a default theme. I hope they decide to keep it going forward. It's also compatible. Vertex and this Vertex Maya theme are compatible with the new versions of GTK3 and GNOME. So if I wanted just to change the theme though, so I'm on Vertex Maya at the moment. Vertex has an absolutely beautiful dark theme, as you can see here. And it also comes with the standard backgrounds, so there's not really too much to shout about here. I could pop this on. You know, it's coming up to summer. They give you some good desktop backgrounds, but they haven't changed them in years, so there's that. I'll keep it on here for the sake of Manjaro, I guess. So they also have this little welcome screen, which is pretty good. It gives you the release information from the distribution. This, of course, has Manjaro 15.12 rather than 16.06, so I don't know if that's a mistake or just part of the early build process. They've got access to the wiki. They've got a readme here, so it talks about all of that kind of stuff. Really quite like this. I think that behind every great distribution that's got at least a dolphin for newbies has a good welcome screen. Now, a lot of people say that Manjaro is arch for beginners to Linux, and I would say that it's I would sort of disagree with that sentiment. I would say that Manjaro is a good start for people looking to get into the Arch distribution and learn how the package manager works and learn, for want of a better expression, the Arch way of thinking. although Manjaro doesn't reflect that in its truest capacity. Manjaro is a great stepping stone to getting used to Arch distributions if you're sort of familiar with its maybe Ubuntu-based distributions. I still reserve that Ubuntu, especially as a base distribution, has the amount of polish and time put into it that it's still the de facto distribution for newcomers. However, the benefits in Manjaro are that it has newer software, and it is a rolling distribution, which means every update completely updates your system to the newest version available for all packages, which means that you often regularly see a lot newer packages in Manjaro than you would do in Ubuntu. In fact, a lot newer, which is the reason that I specifically decide to use Manjaro. Manjaro also have a more rigorous testing process than Arch. They have another couple of weeks of testing on all their packages. So it does feel like Arch with an additional step of stability without compromising too much on the on having the newest software available. It's quite a nice medium. I also find that the community behind Arch are very, very active, very, you know, sort of considerate. They're very, you know, they're really good people that will help you, they'll sort of walk you through the finer points of the distribution if necessary. I've got to say that across the board, even though Manjaro is one of the more polished Arch-based distributions, and it's getting better and better whenever I check up on it, but I still don't feel it's as polished as perhaps either any of the Ubuntu's or Linux Mint, but it's getting there very, very quickly. And when it does get there, it'll sort of surpass those distributions because it has newer software, and it also generally feels a little bit more Linux-y, whereas in the sense that that learning how to use this distribution will give you the tools and the knowledge and the experience to just jump into just about any distribution with at least an idea of what you're doing. I consider this to be an intermediate distribution, whereas you need to have some familiarity with Linux, but not a whole lot. You're going to need to know how to use a command line, but maybe not, it doesn't necessarily have to be your first port of call. You at least have to know sort of how to use it in regards to, you know, reporting errors in programs and putting in, you know, custom commands and that kind of thing. But yes, the Manjaro distribution in its wider capacity has definitely made me appreciate the benefits that rolling distributions have. I say that it's a rolling distribution. It seems to have big updates every couple of weeks, and it seems to do them in stages, which seems to be a little bit of a halfway house between rolling releases and scheduled releases, where you just have a new update once every couple of weeks that'll get everything up to speed. I have, even though with rolling distributions I often say that upgrading can be quite treacherous, I have yet to have a serious problem upgrading Manjaro releases. I did have one problem, which was that I upgraded my XFCE release a couple of weeks ago, and it turned out that my theme wasn't compatible with some of the new GTK tool sets, the GTK, I think it's 3.20. So I had to change my theme, or I had to find a theme that would work with the more updated GTK tool set. But other than that, and again, that's purely a cosmetic error anyway, I gotta say, across the board, Manjaro is a really quite a good distribution for me, and this is just bringing a desktop environment that I really quite like over to it. So it definitely seems to be a decent match. This definitely seems, although it's a community distribution, it definitely seems like it's more stylistically similar to the flagship distributions. So there's that. Also, I'd like to draw to your attention the Manjaro Settings Manager, because this fills in a lot of the gaps that other distributions don't have. It allows you to set system languages. It allows you to install your correct language for all of your packages. So as you can see here, Firefox, Thunderbird, Spellchecker. It wants to install all of these language packs because it knows that I'm British English, and I think the default language of this distribution is American English. So it just wants to make sure that it's got the correct dialect, and that's really, really useful. It means that all of your packages in the repository that are installed onto your computer have the correct language packs associated with them, because it's such a faff. It is such a pain that to have to constantly set up, you know, make sure the right packages, language packages are installed. If you're, of course, speaking American English, this is a problem that you are probably unfamiliar with, but it is very nice to actually make sure that you've just got somewhere to go to with all the language packs readily available, and that's really good. I also really like the the kernel manager, you can actually decide which kernel you want to run. So we've got the long-term support release kernel here running, which is the standard with this distribution, which is a good standard. You can, you know, that's what I would go for. It's recommended, so it tells you which kernel it recommends running. Obviously tells you that it's installed and running. But you can go to 4.5.5.1, or you can go to 4.6-1. So those are newer kernels. They might not be stable, but they might support newer hardware, more sort of exotic hardware. They might, you know, you might get performance improvements. You might get better support for a controller, Steam controller, or the Xbox controller if you're plugging those in. Maybe there might be some Bluetooth gear that you might want working. So so it gives you not only a choice in which kernel you can use, but a pretty informed and easy, you know, like anyone can switch around with kernels now. Also, of course, hardware detection. Ubuntu and Linux Mint have a similar thing where they have a nice little interface where they show you whether or not you can install proprietary drivers or open drivers and all this kind of stuff. So as you can see here, it's a VirtualBox graphics adapter, but it's installed the open source drivers there. So this little Manjaro settings manager, which is included in the XFCE version and the KDE version, and I assume the other community-based distributions as well, is a real nice little addition. Also, you've got date and time. So there you go. What else is there to show you? There's not really that much to show you outside of the, you know, I could show you the package list. It gives you a pretty decent selection of packages. It gives you OpenOffice as default. It gives you Firefox as the default browser, but Chromium is just as easy to install. It gives you the pulse audio volume control, which is a very comprehensive volume control. Prahaga. I doubt I've pronounced that correctly. Prahaga. This is actually new. This is unfamiliar. So this is this just looks like a pretty standard Totem-esque music playlist. In all honesty, I tend not to bother with that kind of stuff. I just tend to go straight into the file manager and then just select my songs as I go, or just whack them onto a VLC playlist or something. But yeah, Manjaro distributions have generally come with a pretty decent selection of software. I have noticed that Steam is not pre-installed on this. So to install software, it's all pretty easy. You just go to System Tools. So you've got Terminal Emulator down there, Xterm. You've got the Welcome screen. You can manage printing. ISO to USB. So GNOME parted or GParted. But yeah, we can just add remove software here. And as you can see, this is how GTK3 based apps look. I really love what they've done with the package manager. It looks really slick, especially in the GTK3 thing layout. I got to admit, it took me a while to get used to the GTK3 toolbar, but I kind of like it now. And it's nice that Mate is getting a little extra support there. So we can install Steam all pretty easily. Steam Manjaro or Steam Native. Let's have a look. And then you can, you can double click on it. And you can check when it was last, you can check the build day, you can check the packager. And you can check, and then you've got like the website and descriptions there. And also the dependencies that it requires. I would assume that Steam Manjaro would be the one that I'd want to install. I'm not going to bother installing it now, because what it does is it downloads like a small daemon, and then it uses that daemon to sort of install Steam. But if I wanted to install Chromium, the open source project behind Google Chrome, I can do that, and I can click apply. And then it's just sort of downloading away. You can check open the details there. But that looked like it may take a while. I've got something downloading in another window, so I will hide it. And then we've got the lock there to tell me that I've got elevated privileges, and there is my music manager, which I will just remove. And then that, so once Chromium is installed, it'll just pop through into the applications menu, as easy as that. Also comes with Firefox and Thunderbird, which are pretty good browsers in my opinion. I got to admit, I personally do err on the side of Chromium, simply because it just manages high memory websites a lot better. And nowadays, I do find that a lot of websites just have just so much JavaScript and bells and whistles on, unnecessary if you ask me. But having a separate process for each tab definitely improves that. So like I said, I think I've shown you just about everything it is that I'd like to show you and tell you about Linux Mint, not Linux Mint, Manjaro Mate Edition. It's a pretty fantastic distribution by the looks of it. Like I said, I'm a big Manjaro user, but I've really only spent the last couple of days just sort of messing around in the virtual machine with the Mate desktop. It is something that, if you're a big fan of the Mate desktop, it is definitely something that I recommend trying. I generally recommend trying Manjaro in, you know, whatever stripes that you feel most comfortable using it in. The KDE desktop is a particularly good one as well. But yeah, I just tend to go for the standard XFCE flagship distribution, simply because I know that it's the most maintained and I quite like XFCE. I'll happily switch to GNOME or Mate, depending on how well it's implemented in the distribution. So that's about it from me today. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know if you have any thoughts on Manjaro. Let me know if you have any thoughts on Manjaro, whether as a Arch-based distribution, whether or not there are other Arch-based distributions you're particularly fond of. Maybe you're an Antergos person. I think there's Architect, that might be one. There was one that was recently added to DistroWatch, which I can't remember the name of now. And of course, there is Pure Arch. I mean, do any of you guys advocate just getting used to the Arch installer and doing everything yourself? Because I've got to admit, just being able to install an Arch distribution in just a matter of a few minutes is really quite appealing. And it's definitely made Arch a more approachable distribution. And I really like that, because Arch has just so much to offer the open source and Linux community. So, and also I feel that it's worth flagging up that there is also an ARM version of Manjaro. So if you have a Raspberry Pi or something to that effect, you can also run Manjaro on this. So that's about it for me today. Thank you very much for watching. Just as a bit of a side note before I wrap up, if you want to listen to a podcast of me and some friends talking about each Game of Thrones episode as it comes up, I'm going to put a link to it down in the description below. Check out the channel that it's on. We have some very in-depth discussions. We often bring up the books and factor them into the episode reviews, and we'll be doing one episode per episode of Game of Thrones. So, you know, we're having a lot of fun recording it, so feel free to check it out. And check out, it's on a different channel, so if you're into that kind of stuff, feel free to subscribe over there. Thanks very much for watching this, and until next time, I've been Chris Ware, and you've been awesome. Take care now.